No, he's
Larry,
sorry.
It's fine.
Larry,
it's
sorry.
Can I have a word for just a second, Larry? Come here. You don't know me. Dave Levin, huh? I'm the Schmuck's brother-in-law. Listen, what you did is a very gutsy thing, okay?
No, I didn't do anything.
You now, let me just say, you know, please, you don't have to take a bow for it. I'm just telling you now. I just do one due to another. It's a gutsy thing to come in and step in on something like that.
I didn't even...
Did you hear that? We're not getting married. You happy now, you son of a bitch?
Excuse me, young lady. Don't call him a son of a bitch. It's not a son of a bitch. This man happened to do a wonderful thing today.
Recognize that guy.
Well, Mr. McCormick.
Someone want to tell me what I'm doing here?
Bosses at every mart have any idea that you're spending time with a guy who's trying to sue him for $2 million?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Okay. Well, maybe this would refresh your memory.
You and Vince Morano were in on the scam together. Easy money, right?
Nah, that's crazy.
Scott Lucas didn't think so.
Who's that?
He was, a private investigator that found out that you and Morano were working together. Same guy you tried to shut up before he could tell anybody else. Now, you want to go to jail for life, or you want to get out where you can still stand upright? Your decision.
Look, we didn't do anything to this guy.
Then tell us what happened.
I got my second moving violation in a month. This punk-ass super, he's looking to put me on probation, all right? And I was 6 months short of my 20.
So I needed a short-term bridge loan.
You call $2 million a short-term bridge loan?
The amount was Vince's idea, and we had to split it.
How did you know Lucas had evidence that you were involved?
I didn't. Lucas interviewed me last week. He wanted my witness statement. When I didn't hear anything about the settlement at work, then I start getting worried, you know? So I thought I better go down there. Hey, I'm sorry, man. You said to contact you if I thought of anything else?
So what do you want?
There's a settlement. I'm gonna lose my job. Right? I'm the one that hit the guy. I thought maybe you could tell me where you're at with the investigation.
Don't give out that kind of information.
Come on. Throw me a bone, huh? I got a family.
Hold on a minute.
Hello? Look, I already told you I'm not donating. Okay? Thank you. Goodbye.
Wow, that's a pretty good gig getting paid to look at that all day, huh?
You gotta get out of here. Look. You're already in trouble. You don't want any more, right?
No, wait a minute. But I just...
Goodbye.
It was the same chick I saw him snooping on.
You're positive?
It's not a rack I'd forget anytime soon.
Don't know how this could have happened. My assistant usually pays such assiduous attention to every detail.
Bear Claw Brauner. You ever hear of him?
Joins a witness relocation program. They send him through medical school. He becomes a fucking doctor.
He decides he doesn't want to kill people anymore. Sick of it. Figures that it's wrong.
Gives up the entire life. That is until the organization sends a couple of men out after him. Oh no, he's not a doctor anymore. Dead. He's a fucking nightmare. Then he becomes a human killing machine.
Hey, Doc.
Mr. Kyle, what can I do for you?
Come here. Look, just between me and you, man to man, what was it?
What was what?
The baby, boy or girl?
I'm sorry, no, I can't tell you that.
Oh, of course you can. Look, I'm no jabber jaw. Now, if it was my wife, the people in the coma ward would know.
Yes, well, it's privileged information.
Okay, you know what? Then point me in the right direction.
All right, how about this one?
Wait, oh!
Oh, you're a funny guy. No colleges.
Okay, look, yeah. You want to play the game? I'll play the game with you. Just cough. Okay? Twice for girl, once for
Mr. Woman. Kyle, I have other patients.
Blink. Just give me a blink. Is that a blink? What? You're blinking.
I really think it's time for you to go.
Okay. I'm sorry.
That's
why I... Whoopsie!
You seem to have dropped something.
Did I? What?
It's $100 bill.
Say what?
That's not mine.
It's not mine. Maybe it's the baby's. Why don't you pick it up and give it back to him or her? Whatever it is, huh?
Tell you what, Kyle, how about this? I can tell you, your baby is gonna be exactly what you want it to be.
Yes! very happy man. Thank you, Doc.
All right.
Pick that up since you're such a stand-up guy. No, no college.
Knock, knock. Oh, hi. Welcome to the Star Princess. I'm your social director, Ted. Just a list of some of the super activities we've got going on.
God, activities.
This is our first trip.
Oh, well, and sir, may I recommend the Deck by Moonlight? You and your lady might enjoy the gorgeous...
Whoa, lady. Oh, this is not my lady, okay? This is my mother.
Oh, sure. Mother. Done.
She really is my mother. Tell him you're my mother.
Oh, honey, look, origami.
Look, what did you write there, okay? Because I'm telling you the truth here.
Oh, it doesn't really matter, sir. We're at sea. You have a grand time, you two.
Hey. We just saw your boyfriend at a bus stop.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, what's his name?
Joel.
Joel what?
Rifkin.
Rifkin? Joel Rifkin?
Yeah, it's just a coincidence, obviously.
Guess you better keep on his good side, huh?
Very funny. That's very funny.
Yeah, I wouldn't sleep with my back to him if I were you.
All right, yeah. That's enough of that.
Hey, Elaine, listen. If you smell anything decaying in the trunk of his car...
Okay, look, this is my boyfriend we're talking about, okay? And he's a gentleman. He's good looking, he's a good shaver, and he hasn't thrown up in 8 years, so just shut up about it.